Today we are going to start a new video segment. Because in the past, all of the derby cars I've ever had on camera or filmed the build progress of, they've either already been in a derby, or like the Thunderbird, it was already stripped when I got it. So the build of the Taurus here is actually going to be the first build you've ever seen on camera that is beginning all the way from start to finish. This car is completely, has all the parts to it, all the interiors all here, it's all complete. So this video segment I'm going to be starting will be covering every area of the car and stripping it out. We will have one segment on the doors and the interior. We will have a segment of under the hood, a segment of all exterior parts, and we will have a section on the trunk, which is what we will be doing today. Trunk is possibly one of the most easiest things to strip out of a vehicle because there's hardly any wiring located in here, and it's mostly big pieces. So I got all the trash taken out of this car and the junk that I had stored in there over winter. It is empty. And you'll notice there's just simple carpeting pieces on the edges here. You pull on those and most of them just rip away to reveal the inside metal. And for the ones that don't rip away, if you look down in there, there's a little black screw right there. Some of the newer cars have these, and they were made for nettings inside the trunk for your groceries or whatever crap you wanted to throw in here, maybe some bodies or something. But if you unscrew these black things, they will help you rip out the carpets a lot easier. As you can see, I'm doing with this one right here. There we go. Just looks like that. It's a little plastic hook. Just unscrew those. There's four of them in this trunk. Every vehicle is different. Some of them might not even have them. There's one there, one later on down here by the trunk, and the one I just pulled from there. So two on each side. I'm gonna throw those in our trash can for now. So I'm gonna pull those out. Back in the back panel, you will see the controls for your speakers in the car are located back here. You have some wiring for your fuel pump, wiring for speakers, and there should be wiring that go to your taillights in the car. That will be back along here. On this side, which this is a common thing for a lot of Ford cars, my Lincoln had this, this Taurus has it, my Sable has this feature. On the left side here, usually they're right here's the left of the car, right behind the flap, or they're right under the speaker deck right there, is the emergency fuel shutoff switch, known as the inertia switch. Whenever a car gets in an accident, based on how fast you're going, that switch will trigger itself and shut off. That turns your fuel pump off, so that's why your car can't catch on fire as easy during an accident. Well, obviously for a derby, you're going to be getting hit a lot, so you don't want that switch to just shut off on you, and I have seen this happen during compact derbies. During a stock class, some people forget to change that wire, and after the very first hit, the car just shuts off and they can't figure out why it won't start. Well, that's your reason. If it ever shuts off, you just have to push that button and it resets it until the next hit. So we will get to that later when we wire up our car and hook up the electronic fuel pump and get all that done, but we'll come back to that. For now, we're just going to remove all this carpeting, and of course we have the spare tire area that can come out first. So throw that aside outdoors right now. Great weather today. Less rain than what we've had lately. Really nice. So we have our spare tire, which I'm not sure if this is a 14 or 15 inch rim. I'll have to check and see. If it's a 14 inch rim, I can use that on the back of this car for one of my donut tires. And of course we have a mouse nest. How convenient. Let's see if there's anything in it. Bag of poison, that's empty. This will have to all get unscrewed off, which unfortunately the plastic screw thing is broken. That kind of sucks. Figures, stupid Taurus, everything's broken on this car. But this has to get unscrewed so we can remove our spare tire. God, God, it smells like rat pee in here. Rat piss, real strong. Damn mice. I'm sure we're gonna find at least a good 10 of them nesting here somewhere. Probably all under the seats inside the car. Anywho, we removed our nut for the spare tire. And that's my scrap metal bin. Just an old drawer. Always keep anything that's metal. Whether it's a screw, a nut, a bolt. If you take it off a car, keep it. Because it's scrap. And it will all add up. Just like pennies. All adds up to a big amount. But we have a jack here. And this is a good clean jack. So I'm going to hang on to that. I might need it. And now let's go ahead and get this stupid tire out of here. Oh, look, there we go. Casualty number 3. There's another dead mouse. That one's actually starting to turn into a skeleton. It's been here a while. It's gross. So let's go ahead and pull this tire out of here. What size is this? Oh, good. Right there. This is a 14-inch rim. So I will be using this rim on the car. This will be one of the spare donut tires to go on the rear wheels. Good deal. And that's about it. See if there's any more mice around here. Stir things up a bit. Nope, nothing else. Alright, I'm going to go ahead and mount the camera over here on the trunk of the Thunderbird. I have it on a stand. And you guys can see me strip out the rest of the trunk. This camera decides to stay for me. Hopefully it doesn't fall over while I'm filming. Alright. Your camera's good. Alright, that was easy. There's pretty much everything in one giant chunk. Wow. And then this car had it in one piece. Some of them have three pieces. They got one on each sidewall and then one on the floor. Nope, one piece for this car. That's nice. So, look at the trunk of this car. That is a clean trunk. Check that out. Besides the massive mouse turds that are covering the floor. And somehow there's a bunch of mud in here. I don't really want to know how that got in here. Otherwise, yes, very clean car. No rust anywhere in sight in here. Not even a speck. And all the broken light bulbs are back here. And, oh, look at that. There's casualty number 4. Another dead mouse. Let's see how many we can add up by the time we're done stripping this car out. I was surprised. I was expecting more on the floor. There's our tools of trade. Today's weapons we're going to be using. Of course, your hammer. So, the head is cleaned out. Bada bing, bada boom. Stage 1 is done. On to the next part of the car.